your service. Kaya naman, ang feedback mo, suggestions nyo ay mahalaga sa amin to improve our programs on air and online. Para alam ni teacher yung strengths as well as the things in your mind na mas makatutulong sa mas effective na pagkatuto sa teleradyo. Please take time to send your feedbacks via teleradyo Mew, which you can access by scanning the QR code on the right or typing the URL provided here, bit.ly/3ORVAY9. One more, this time you follow. bit.ly/3ORVAY9. Kaya send your hashtag TBH o hashtag RT dito sa Teleradyo Mew kung saan ang feedback mo, suggestions nyo ay mahalaga sa Teleradyo.
Makinig, manood na sa teleradyo. Makinig, manood na sa teleradyo. Teleradyo, Teleradyo Marcelo. Sa gitna ng mapanubok na panahon, magkahatid sa kakibat ay diskusyon. Sama-sama tayo kahit magkalayo sa programang ito, tiyak ang pagkatuto. Teleradyo, Teleradyo Marcelo. Teleradyo, Teleradyo Marcelo. Teleradyo, Teleradyo Marcelo.
Hello! Good day, Grade 7 students! Welcome to Teleradyo Marcelo, ang telearalan ng bawat Del Pilarian at ng batang Maluleño. This is again, Ma'am Roan Laika B. Pasubilio, your English teacher today. Welcome again, class, and I hope you are all doing fine today. Before we start our class today, I would like to greet our beloved principal, Dr. Maria Victoria C. Vivo, our English department head, Ma'am Purificacion Pagiligan, our English master teacher for grade 7, Ma'am Mary Batongbakal, and of course, the rest of the faculty of Marcelo H. Del Pilar National High School. Good morning, everyone. Today, class, we will have a new lesson. But before that, let us first have a recall of our lesson last week. What was our lesson last week? You can type your answers in our comment box and I will give you 15 seconds to answer. Okay, time's up, class. What was our lesson last week? You are correct. Our lesson last week was about the nonverbal and the verbal communication. We also talk about the nonverbal communication strategies. That is very good. I'm glad that you learned something from your previous lesson. Before we go to our lesson for today, let me remind you of some house rules you have to follow so that you can have a fruitful learning experience. Okay, first, make sure you are using only one gadget. If you have another one, shut it off so that you can concentrate. Second, have a pen and paper in front of you so that you can take down important notes. Three, listen intently to the teacher so that you can easily do the tasks later. Four, you are expected to be interactive. You can join in the discussion by using our chat box. Comments should only be about the lesson. And when you are answering my questions, don't forget to write your section. Five, be respectful of others' comments or ideas. And finally, relax, sit back, and enjoy. So now let's talk about our today's topic. Today's topic is determining the worth of ideas mentioned in the text listened to. This was written by Ma'am Mary L. Batumbaka. At the end of the lesson, you are expected to process information mentioned in the text listened to, make simple inferences about thoughts and feelings expressed in the text listened to, and lastly, determine the worth of ideas mentioned in the text listened to. Now, class, before we move on to our topic for today, I have a question for you. What woke you up this morning? Was it an alarm clock? Was it the crowing of the hens or the dog barking? Was it mother snagging? You can type your answer in our comment box. Now, whatever it is that woke you up, be glad you were awake. Our lesson today has something to do with listening. If you woke up because of the given reasons, your sense of hearing is working. Now, let us activate your senses. Take a look at the different pictures that I will show you. And let us answer the following questions, okay? Now, let's look at the first picture. What do you see in the first picture? You are correct. This is a picture of the baby crying. Now, my next question is, why do you think is he doing that? Why is the baby crying? You can type your answers in our comment box. You must include your section. Okay, your answers are amazing. Maybe the baby is crying because maybe he is hungry. Okay, so maybe that's why. Okay, next picture. What about this? What did the boy do in the second picture? The boy? Very good. The boy slammed the door. And what was the woman's reaction? Yes, you're correct. The woman was shocked on the action of the boy. Good job. Last picture. What about this? What happened to the girl's umbrella and why? Yes, you are correct. The girl's umbrella was blown by the wind. Very good. Now, my next question is, what helped you come up with your answers? Is it because of the pictures? Yes or no? Very good answers. Now, class, what do you think is the difference between listening and hearing? You can answer my questions using our comment box. Don't forget to include your section. I will give you 15 seconds to answer. Timer starts now. Okay, time's up, class. Those are good answers. Now let us take a look. What is the difference between listening and hearing? When we say hearing, it is an accidental and automatic brain response to sound that requires no effort. For example, we are familiar to the sounds of the siren, of the ambulance, the laughter of our friends, and so on. We hear those incidental sounds and we train ourselves not to give too much attention to them unless we have a reason to do otherwise. We filter the things we hear unless it seems important to us. So that is hearing, that is an accidental and automatic brain response to the sound. What about listening? Listening, on the other hand, is purposeful and focused rather than accidental. To listen well means to be motivated to understand the meanings. It is an active, focused, and concentrated attention for the purpose of understanding the meaning of the speaker. Listening well is a skill that will help you get by, class. You listen for instructions and thus know what to do. You listen to the newscasts and thus know the latest news. You listen to commentators' views and comments and thus find yourself forming your own opinions on current issues. Every day of your life, there is so much to listen to. Teachers explain lessons. Classmates discuss something or give a report. School officials give short talks during convocations. Speakers talk on topics that concern you. At home, parents give advice. Mother gives you instructions or directions on things that you need to be done. If you know how to listen very well, and if you take the effort to listen, understand what is said, and remember it, then you have acquired the skill. In listening, it is very important to determine the significance of ideas in a text listened to. In doing so, skills like getting the gist of a text and making inferences about thoughts and feelings expressed in a text should be mastered. Inference is about using observation and background to reach a logical conclusion. You probably practice inference every day. For example, if you see someone eating a new food and he makes a face, then you infer that he does not like the food at all. If someone slams the door, you can infer that she or he is upset about something. It is an idea or conclusion that is drawn from evidence or reason. It can also be considered as an educated guess. Now, how to listen effectively? First is you need to listen carefully to the main ideas. Listen carefully to know what the topic is about. Second, listen for keywords. You can take down notes, important details when you are listening. And lastly, think about what you are listening to. Sorting out the main idea and the supporting details or supporting ideas help you to really understand the meaning of the speaker. Let's now talk about determining the worth of idea. How can we determine the worth of idea? Speakers can create hundreds of ideas, but not all these ideas are worth to remember. Most of them can deliver introductory messages or speeches that are not so important in giving information about their topic. These are called flowery words. They just give life to their speech. So, for us to determine the worth of idea or the value of idea, we need to look at how rare it is and how worth keeping it is. Be guided to the following guide questions for you to determine the worth of idea. First question or first guide question is, what is the topic of the text you are listening to? What is the main idea? Second, what is the important idea presented in the text? Third, how is the idea being presented? Is it explicitly stated or implied? Class, when we say explicit, it means that it is clearly stated. And when it is implied, it means that it is hidden. Okay? Number four, what helped you determine the worthy ideas presented? Is it about the speaker's voice or by using different discourse markers? And number five, is the idea presented worth keeping and worth sharing to others? Now that you know how to determine the worth or value of an idea, let's try this. Listen to the questions attentively, then choose the correct answer. Again, class, you can answer in our comment box. Do not forget to include your section, okay? First, number one. Okay, let's have number one. When you look for the worth of ideas from the message of a speaker, you are actually looking for the, is it A, funny jokes uttered, B, the essence of the talk that can be applied to your life, C, most interesting facts of the talk, and letter D, notable styles in engaging his audience. Timer starts now. Time's up, class. What is your answer? Is your answer letter B? Okay, the correct answer is letter B. When you look for the worth of ideas from the message of a speaker, you are actually looking for the essence of the talk that can be applied to your life. Let us continue. Number two. It requires you to listen attentively when you listen to, is it A, showbiz report of your favorite actress? B, a song to appreciate its tune and rhythm? C, your friend sharing his or her successes in life? Or D, your teacher giving instructions for your upcoming test? Again, class, comment your answers in our chat box. Do not forget to include your section. Time's up, class. The correct answer is letter D. It requires you to listen attentively when you listen to your teacher giving instructions for your upcoming test. Last number. Hearing is A, or an blank, an automatic brain response to sound that requires no effort. Is it A, accidental, B, focused, C, intentional, or D, voluntary? Time's up. Our answer is, okay, you are correct. It is letter A. Hearing is an accidental and automatic brain response to sound that requires no effort. Very good answers again, class. Now let us see how well you listened. Let's do the next activity. Activity 2. This time is you will listen to the conversation that I will read to you, then answer the questions using our chat box. Are you ready? Let's begin. Look at the long line. Do you think we will get in? I think so. Some of these people already have tickets. How much are the tickets? Only 100 pesos for the first show. I will pay. Thanks. I will buy the popcorn. Okay, now class, let us answer the following questions. First one. These people are in the... Is it A, market? B, cinema? C, department store? Or D, library? Comment your answers in our chat box. Don't forget to include your section. Time's up. Our answer is letter B. Okay, these people are in the cinema. Good job. Okay, let's continue to question number 2. What will they do? Is it A, buy supplies, B, shop for clothes, C, watch a movie, or D, read a book? Time's up. What is your answer? Yes, you're correct. This is letter C. They will watch a movie. Okay, next one. Who are the persons talking? Is it A, friends, B, siblings, C, father and mother, or D, cousins? Time's up. They are, yes, you're correct again, letter A. Good job. They are friends. Okay, now let us have another activity. Again, class, listen attentively to this conversation. Let us start. This is one of the reasons I hate working in a big city. I know every day is the same thing. This is terrible. We may be here all night. I hope we don't run out of gas. No, I think there is enough. Let us turn on the radio. Maybe there is some good music. Sorry, the radio is not working. I think I will take the train tomorrow. Now let us answer the following questions. Number 1. Where were the two persons going? Is it A, to the mall, B, to school, C, to work, or D, to the library? Okay, our answer is letter See, they will go to work. Okay, next. Where were they at the moment? A, inside a train. B, inside a car. C, inside a bus. Or D, inside an airplane. Time's up, class. A, B, C, or D, the correct answer is they are inside a car. Letter B, they are inside a car. Okay, next one. What did they encounter? A, an accident. B, a free ticket to a concert. C, a construction going on. Or D, a traffic jam. Time's up again. The correct answer is they encountered letter D, a traffic jam. Next, number four. Do you think Cardo will be riding in Kula's car again? Is it a yes or a no? The correct answer is a no. Okay, last question, number five. You can infer that Kulas is pissed off or Kulas is ungrateful. Time's up, class. What can you infer in the conversation? It is Kulas is pissed off. Very good, class. So now for more practice, listen to the next videos and let us check your comprehension. After this one, class, you can pass your answers to your English subject teacher. Let's start the first video. Okay, that is the first video. Number one, the first question is, why is the dog barking? Number two, what makes you think so? And number three, you made an inference. What might be the proofs or evidences that will justify your answer? So that is the first video. Let's move on to the second video. Let's play the video. Okay, there you go. Number one question. What is likely to happen if you hear this, noise or this sound? And number two, can children play outdoors? Why or why not? Last video is this. Let us listen. Okay, now answer the following questions again. Number one, why does it make the sound or that sound? Number two, where is the ambulance heading to? And number three, what should drivers do when they hear the siren? That is activity four. Now for our activity five is listen to the weather forecast tonight of your favorite weather reporter, Kuya Kim Atienza of TV Patrol in ABS-CBN or Mang Tani of Saksip in GMA 7. Answer the following questions in any sheet of paper and then your English teacher will check it. Number one, what kind of weather are we going to have the next day? Do we have to bring our umbrellas or raincoats in case it rains? Will mother be able to wash clothes then? Is it a good day for outdoor activities? What makes you think so? And lastly, cite some facts mentioned by the weather reporter that made you come up with the inferences. Well, this is the end of our lesson today. Remember this class, listening attentively is a very good sign of reading. It is a good sense as well. I hope that you learned something new and worthwhile. This has been your Mom Roan once again, saying thank you, keep safe, and God bless. See you next week, class!
Is always at your service. Kaya naman, ang feedback mo, suggestions nyo ay mahalaga sa amin to improve our programs on air and online. Para alam ni teacher yung strengths as well as the things in your mind na mas makatutulong sa mas effective na pagkatuto sa Teleradyo. Please take time to send your feedbacks via Teleradyo Mu, which you can access by scanning the QR code on the right or typing the URL provided here, bit.ly/3ORVAY9. One more, this time you follow. bit.ly/3ORVAY9. Kaya send your hashtag TBH o hashtag RT dito sa Teleradyo Mu kung saan ang feedback mo, suggestions nyo ay mahalaga sa Teleradyo.
Makinig, manood na sa Teleradyo. Makinig, manood na sa Teleradyo. Teleradyo, Teleradyo Marcelo. Sa gitna ng mapanubok na panahon, magkahatid sa kakibat ay diskusyon. Sama-sama tayo kahit magkalayo sa programang ito, tiyak ang pagkatuto. Teleradyo, Teleradyo Marcelo. Teleradyo, Teleradyo Marcelo. Teleradyo, Teleradyo Marcelo. Teleradyo, Teleradyo Marcelo.